What are the dream matchups that could happen this year? Let's talk about that. So, the stats that I'm going to mention are by WrestleStat. Make sure you check out WrestleStat, which is a great news site to check all your statistics on wrestling. Now, talking about dream matchups, we're going to go weight by weight, talking about which dream matchups we could see this year. So, at 125 pounds, the first dream matchup that I want to mention is Jack Mueller versus Nick Piccinini. And the first thing I'm going to mention is I'm not just talking about all one versus two guys. I'm talking about some guys that are number three versus number four, number five, whatever it is. It's not just all number one and two, because of course everybody wants to see number one and number two, and I'll get to a couple of those. But first up, Jack Mueller versus Nick Piccinini. Mueller's number two, Piccinini's number four right now. Mueller out of Virginia last year had a outstanding season, was undefeated going into the national tournament, into the national finals, actually, whenever he ended up being defeated by Spencer Lee. Now, what's interesting here is Piccinini, of course, has a win last season on Spencer Lee earlier in the season against a duel. Now, these two have not wrestled before, but they do have many, many common opponents. One of those, of course, being Spencer Lee. They will wrestle next, probably not until a national tournament. Who do I predict is going to win? I have to say, I think this is the year for Nick Piccinini. I think he's going to have a phenomenal season, and I'm interested to see what he does. And as I'm going through all these, please let me know what your dream matchups would be. Now, at 133 pounds, an interesting matchup here would be Seth Gross versus Mickey Philippi. Now, why Mickey Philippi out of all guys? Why is this a number one versus number four matchup? Why I think this would be a great matchup, because these two haven't wrestled in the past, is these two have some pretty funky styles. I think they would kind of combat well against each other, and I'm interested in seeing what that, you know, Wisconsin versus Pitt would be. Now, they have not wrestled before, like I said, but Gross is 16-0 against all of Mickey Philippi's common opponents. Now, we don't know when they'll wrestle next, because Wisconsin is going to Midlands, Pitt's going to the scuffle. They could meet at the national tournament, depending on where they fall in the bracket. That's probably where we'll see them next. Who do I think is going to win? I think Gross is going to win with that year off and kind of with some time to readjust and get some more training in. I think Gross is going to be the superior opponent here, but like I said, both funky styles, and we've seen Mickey Philippi knock off top guys before, like Dayton Fix last season. At 141 pounds, number two, Nick Lee versus number three, Luke Pletcher. If you haven't heard yet, Luke Pletcher is bumping up a weight to wrestle 141 pounds. This is relatively new news and something that I thought was very important to discuss. So Nick Lee versus Luke Pletcher, what could this match look like? We've seen some great matches between Penn State and Ohio State in the past, and that's probably when they're going to meet first, is in this duel between Penn State and Ohio State in February. Now, we've seen Nick Lee knock off last year Joey McKenna, who ended up making the national finals, but we've seen him knock off in the duel, and I think that could happen again this year. I don't know what's going to happen in this match, but my prediction is that because Nick Lee is coming in hot this season, he had a great season last year and can, you know, really showed up against opponents in duels, I think that Nick Lee is going to win. But I'll tell you what, Pletcher is stacked, he's jammed, and he can always keep any type of match close, and Nick Lee tends to have a lot of close matches as well. Now, at 149 pounds, who is a dream matchup here? Let's call this the Battle of the Freshmen, because we have Brayton Lee versus Sammy Sasso. This is number 11, Brayton Lee out of Minnesota versus number 5, Sammy Sasso out of Ohio State. Sasso is a guy right now who a lot of people, there's a lot of chatter talking about Sasso becoming a national champion in his freshman year. Is it possible? Let me know. I think it is totally possible that it could happen. Now, these two are one of the first matchups that have actually wrestled in the past before. So they have wrestled in their redshirt year last season, whenever Sammy Sasso had a 6-4 decision over Brayton Lee. That was in their redshirt year. Now, the next time they'll meet is versus Minnesota versus Ohio State. That match, that duel is happening in January. That's probably the first time we're going to see it. Who are we going to see win that? I think Sasso. He edged him out before, and I think that there's a good chance that he's going to edge him out again. Next up at 157 pounds, we're halfway through these dream matchups. These dream matchups in number one, Hayden Hiley versus number three, Ryan Deacon. Deacon out of Northwestern, of course, Hiley out of NC State. Hiley is coming in hot this season after a very controversial match in the semifinals last year against Jason Nolf. He's no longer in his way, and we could definitely see Hiley taking that national title, but there are going to be a couple of guys in his way, such as Ryan Deacon. Now, these two have wrestled again in the past. They will be wrestling again, possibly at the Cliff King Las Vegas in December. Last time they wrestled, Hiley won 8-2. That was at the national tournament last year. Now, who's going to win next? I think Hiley is probably going to win next, even though Deacon had a great season last year. He's a great wrestler. 32-7 actually was his record last year, but I see Hayden pulling that victory out at 165. Now, I mentioned, of course, that I have to talk about a couple number ones versus number twos, and I think this is everybody's dream matchup again at 165, is Alex Marinelli versus Vincenzo Joseph. These two have clashed in the past before multiple times. Well, just twice, actually, but they have clashed in the past when Marinelli is 2-0 against Vincenzo Joseph. Vincenzo just can't seem to get his hands on Marinelli, can't seem to figure him out, his style. This could be the year that he does figure it out. Now, Marinelli is one of the only guys who has beaten Vincenzo Joseph two times, the other guy being Isaiah Martinez, of course, a couple of years ago. Now, these two will wrestle next, Iowa versus Penn State. We could see them wrestling multiple times, which I think is very exciting for the wrestling community. We could see them in the duel. We could see them at Big Tens and at Nationals, possibly all in the finals, depending on how their seasons stack out, because we all know that an early season loss could lead to an early matchup at the national tournament. At 174, another semi, controversial duel is, of course, always Penn State versus Iowa. And this year, Mark Hall will be wrestling Michael Kemmer at 174 pounds. Now, what I want to mention as an honorable mention, be a fun dream match would be Mark Hall versus Anthony Valencia, which is most likely going to happen again whenever Penn State versus Arizona State early in the season, but mostly just because Zahid and Mark have had such a big rivalry in the past that I want to see him wrestle his brother. So, Hall versus Kemmer. Now, we see that Kemmer is bumping up a weight this year, a couple weights actually, from 157 to wrestle 174 after an injury last season. Now, these two have not wrestled in the past because of that, and it's going to be exciting to see how they do. Now, they are both undefeated against common opponents, and there aren't too many because of the weight change because of that. We'll see them wrestle in January during the duel. My next winner, who I think is going to win, is going to be Mark Hall. Kemmer may have a little bit of trouble bumping up a weight. We'll see how that turns out. Of course, it's a half season under his belt by then, so we'll see how he does. Now, at 184, another guy who's bumping up is Zahid Valencia. Zahid Valencia is, of course, the other guy who's bumping up this year, and he will be wrestling in a dream matchup, Ben Darmstadt out of Cornell. Now, Zahid and Ben could be a very exciting duel. Why? Ben's dropping down, Zahid is bumping up. So we have two guys who are both, I mean, Zahid is just stacked. He's jammed. Had an incredible last season, although he did have a couple of losses. Now, Darmstadt, if you're unfamiliar with him, he ended up having take a year off last year, took a redshirt year. Now, he did All-American at 197 pounds, Darmstadt out of Cornell, but because he's dropping down, that is pretty big and could be a major factor in a duel against the Heat. Now, how do these two stack up? I still see Zahid. I still think he's massive for 184. He's still technical, a very technical wrestler, and I think he has that against Darmstadt. And now, they have not wrestled in the past before. There aren't any common opponents, but they will be wrestling next at the Cliff King Las Vegas. If they end up making up those matchups, if they end up wrestling, it could be there. If not, we will probably see them at the national tournament. Two more weights for you guys. At 197, Colin Moore versus Kyle Connell. This is another Penn State versus Ohio State matchup. Connell, of course, coming out of Kent State, transferred to Penn State this year. They have wrestled in the past. They wrestled in Cleveland at the national tournament. Now, they wrestled when they wrestled then, it was just kind of like Connell was just another guy that Connell Moore was just supposed to pretty much put the hammer down, crush him. But Connell came out of nowhere and stuck Colin Moore. It was the biggest match of the tournament, I think, by far. It was the most exciting match. But not only did he pin him then, they ended up wrestling in the wrestlebacks whenever Colin Moore lost again to Kyle Connell, lost a close match. Their last match was 5-3. Now, we could see them wrestle again, Penn State versus Ohio State. Who do I think is going to win next? That's a tough one. I think Connell has just a couple more opponents in the room who he's now training with. Of course, he has great practice partners now, and Anthony Cassar, Bo Nickel in the room. He'll have Kyle Snyder, who's kind of snuck away from Colin Moore. So I think that puts Connell at a little bit of an advantage, and we've seen that he can beat him in the past. So why can't it happen now that he's transferred to Penn State? At 285 pounds, the big heavyweight matchup that I want to see. Yes, of course, I want to see Anthony Cassar versus Gable Steveson. That is a massive match, but that's not my dream match. My dream match is number 9, Anthony Cassiope versus number 11, Mason Paris. Why? I feel like these are two of the biggest heavyweights that are talked about, possibly even more than Cassar and Steveson going into this season, because people just want to see how they do. Of course, Mason Paris very well at international success, as well as Cassiope, they both have. Now, these two have not wrestled in college yet, but they have met at the national championships, cadet junior national championships, whenever Cassiope teched Mason Paris. Could that happen again? We'll see in the duel with Iowa versus Michigan. Now, I think that Cassiope is going to win that. Being an Iowa wrestler, I think that, you know, showing that he teched him before is very possible. Of course, now that we're going to wrestle in freestyle, we'll see what happens.